Hello for Friday, July 28th, and you see here 5 days down in a row for the Dow. Of course, we did have six over here in the end of May, June, you know, when we pulled down, so maybe one more day. The jobs report came out. I think it was 398,000, somewhere around there, was the new filings for unemployment. Maybe it was made up number, maybe it was because of the hot weather and people didn't file, but at any rate, being under that 400,000, and most days you would expect to see a good rally, but with the Congress still, sitting on their hands and not getting the country's work done, the market didn't like that, and of course it dropped some more. We're now under the Bollinger Band, as you see here, so we're going to move back either Friday or Monday. We're going to have to get a bounce because it's not going to, believe me, it's not going to stand in there. You could have a huge drop or even a market crash, but it's not going to stay there. It just doesn't do it. It bounces. We take a look at the, what do we have first? I think we have probably a long-term here. Look, this is the futures. This is a 360-minute chart, and here you can see the break below that support. It did well. It bounced above it there up to the pivot point of the day and then came back down. And then, of course, in the last 360 minutes, last few hours of the day, it did fall and fell below, going down and bounced it basically at the S1 and came back up a little bit from there. What happened to my chart? Anyway, I'll switch back over if we can to it. I think it's still here. It's just something to do with the computer memory or something I pushed. If we do continue this, looking at this, this is up from the high up here, as you can see, down to this break below this low in that time frame, meaning the daily time frame, then we have a 127 possible. And you can look left and see that's also, you saw the same thing yesterday. Anyway, 12,106 if we continue down that route. We can look at a shorter term and see what happened during the overnight. Now, in the overnight, the short did get covered right there as it bounced up. And this is on a 10-minute chart, on a 5-minute chart we were using before, and that did get covered basically in that area. And we said it's going to be choppy. Anyway, after the change of the date, here we have 7:28, so that's the not the session time, but the actual calendar date change. Then we had a rally. It moved up to this level, then it came down and made a low, and as it moved back up again, the Fib target from this low up to the high, a break on that would give it a 127 projection, and sure enough, that's where it went to. Couldn't get above it, I mean just a little bit, but it basically stayed right there at the pivot point of the day, and that's where it fell all day long. Now if we look in the after hours, this is that the market's been closed already for I guess 3.5 hours or so, and we can look from this high down to that low there, what a projection was on the downside, down to 161 at 12,155. So this is short term thing to look at overnight. We have held that, so we can hold that level. You're looking for a breakout here or a crossing of the averages, and maybe we can get some kind of rally going in that behalf. You can take a look at that chart or some that are posted. I think we posted that one, and you can see that in the Twitter stream. Okay, this is the weekly, once again, of the Russell, just to show the setup. It's still above, clearly above this support, the 50-week and below the 20-week. And the short term on that also, it's not as bad as it may seem in that it's lost all this gains up here. But at the same time, we're above this support at 7.95. So maybe you can hold that. You note that RSI is still under 30, but it moved above it shortly. And sometimes it only takes two times to try. So it's back under it a little bit. Maybe the next time we can get a decent working rally going. In fact, before I go to that, let's just see if I happen to have any additional information using the futures. And we do. And that is, we posted this chart as well, is that this is a parallel channel. So we've had two and now three touches on the bottom. So obviously a breakdown here is not good. And this projection, 783. But it's right around this 127 area. Bounced up to the test, the break out, or the breakdown, and that got shorted as it should be. I mean, that's the normal place you short, right? You break support, you run back up to it. If you can't go over, you short it. So they did. But if we can hold, even though this trend's going down, if it can stay above the trend line, the next time it breaks above, it could hold and maybe go up to the top line. Anyway, be aware that you're on your own charts. We are in at the moment in a parallel channel, which may mean something. And on the daily SPX cash, you can see we're still above that 1295 area. But if you look here on the futures, and the numbers will be, that's not that futures, we'll get to that in a moment. You can see it tried to get above this little triangle that we have and then drop below as well. And 1292.51 would be where this low was before in the futures, a couple points different than the cash. But if we break below that, then we've got both the 78.6 retracement from the total move up and the projection level at 12, actually that's just, I think, 78.6. That would be at 1,277. Okay, since we had that other chart open, let's get back to it, because I don't like it, though. It can change. However, this is the Euro futures, and you can see it broke below this trend line. You don't see the bottom of it, but you've seen it before, and it's been posted. But it broke below it, and now it's going up. Now, if it goes sideways a while and then shoots up, it'll be much, maybe a better chance of getting back over this line. At the moment, it's really bearish flag looking, like it was just before. So it dropped, went into a little flag, dropped, and now it's in a flag. It could drop again. And generally, if the euro drops, the market drops with it. But pay attention to what the euro is doing. And you can see if we switch over to the dollar, if we have that, the DX. And you can see there was a little bit of a rally there, and then it pulled back as well. So if this may continue to rally, the euro would drop, and probably the market would drop. But anyway, something to pay attention to. And gold, I don't think I have futures on gold. It didn't do too much during the day. You can see up a little bit, $4.40, but GDX was down. This is now the third candle down, so we're up on it with a short at 559.25, and it was closed at 56.13. So it's been a good trade up for $5 and a couple bucks already on the downside. Meanwhile, silver, the SLV mechanical, is still holding its upside. So let's get to what happened as far as the stocks went for the day. And a few stocks did move with little gaps, and ones that we said this was a trade because it just looked like a good trading setup. Because when you have these overhead, when you have this kind of base, and we had an improved volume a couple days before, and then you've got a gap overhead, it doesn't mean it's going to go into it, but a lot often it'll do just like this. You can see it close right at the gap, so it may have a chance now. You can watch it for a possible trade over that gap, but it was a good trade during the day. It gapped up a little bit, you could have bought it, and it ran up as high as 148, so, and it closed up 14%. It was up quite a bit higher percentage wise, so that one was a good trade. And right now it's a good idea to do some short term trades if you see them with the market. You know, until we resolve this issue, it's going to go up and down probably, and maybe mostly down anyway. But sometimes, like with Crocs, you know, it broke out and then it pulled back a couple of days, but it held, went, came down right to that 20-day, and basically, well, you can see it gapped up, and then it ran up nicely. It was up 15% on the day. BC was a new one for the day. I think we put it on the watch list yesterday. Netflix also gapped up. It didn't close as high. It went up pretty high, up to 23, and then came right back down here. But at good volume, if the market improves, this is one to watch. It's likely that we may be able to get back into that one for a run. Other things like J&J did trigger on the short side, but just didn't have any heart in it, and it closed just below that 64.70 area, and or got as low as 64.78 is all. That's the 64.70 was the low that it was before. Anyway, it closed basically at the line or just a little bit below that one. And I think that's all of those. So additions we have to the watch list are mixed, both longs and shorts. But a few of these are trading one. Once again, if you got a weak market, people do like to still trade. They like to get in and out, remember. And anyway, PRKR, Parker Vision. You can see it had a great two-day run-up, and it's been consolidating here. Volume's been less, but still 650,000 shares. So this is a trade somewhere in the area, 128-130 looks like. Obviously, you don't want it if it drops below this lower support area, but still could be a trade. Maybe it could test the 147, and these low-dollar stocks, a low, you know, it's a dollar something, so you don't have, you move up 15 cents, and you've gone up 10%. It's fun. AMD, It had a nice move up. It must have been an earnings move. Gapped up, and it's been coming down on much lower volume. It's got a nice flag going here. So far, it's held the 50-day. Now, if that breaks, it could maybe drop quickly down to test its gap support. But we don't have it set up as a short. We're watching it for, just pay attention to it. If it has volume coming into it, or if the semis happen to move, or some other stock, in another semiconductor, this might move in sympathy along with it. The top line, obviously, the 783 is a 200-day, so a break above that. But watch it, see if it moves out of the flag, like say, you know, depends on where what day it is, maybe 775, maybe 765. It really depends on when it happens. But a good volume, we loved little flag breaks. They can work out real well, at least short term. Another flag then is OMX, Office Max. This is just looks like an interesting chart. The trend line is just from this gap down candle up at the top here in late April, and then hit an 828, and then it broke above that, and it's flagged also, and it's held basically around this 20-day. It's got a 50-day problem up here. I mean, in other words, it has to break above that eventually. 791 is a 50-day, but I think you can play it maybe 740, 750, 760 on good volume breaking out of this flag. Look at your short-term charts on this, but this looks like this could be one that moves. Obviously, on all the stocks, as we mentioned, check to see when the earnings are, and don't be surprised. Okay, TAOM, 600,000 share volumes. Okay, you can see another one, possibility of a trader here. It's been consolidating. It's just kind of, you can't say exact prices on this, but look for yourself. Maybe 16.50, maybe 17, somewhere in here. It could be one for short-term scalp. It just looks like it's a nice, pretty clean chart here. So it hasn't been trading, of course, very long. Doesn't have a lot of history to it, but it's had some action during the day. What was it up? 3.94%. So that one you might want to trade. Now on the downside, you got Capital One. Doesn't look too good. And, you know, the financial has not been good. It's closed second day in a row now under its 200-day. It did that before 2 days and it bounced. Any of these could be a bounce play, obviously. It closed up here for the day, but it's not a good candle at all. But it still could bounce anyway. Under, if it gets back under this 47.55, could short, or the 47.33. If it is successful and starts to short down, notice that the Bollinger Band's down here at 45, whatever it is, down here at, I can't quite read, it's very small, 46.21, I guess. Yes. So, but eventually, if this does break that support and starts going down, then we're looking at this $42 to $43 area where it had the support before, so it might be support. Again, it was resistance before, so it might be support this time. Okay, back to another one, and this was on our watch list already, and then it fell off for so many days. We wanted over this 383 or maybe this 265 area right here. Maybe we said 265. Anyway, it fell down so many days, we just turned it gray. We said, we're not interested until it has some movement. Well, it did have movement. It moved over that 20-day, and going up towards the 50-day, it closed underneath that. So you'd be the judge. 383 would be where the line is. A little bit lower, is 371 is the 50-day. Maybe that's the point. But it moved back up. There's still interest, and it had higher volume on TLB. Now, feed was on the watch list and triggered down at $1.30, and it's now $1.80. So it's been a good mover, and the volumes hasn't been great the last couple of days, but look, it's steady. It looks like it wants to try again, so it can be over 380. Over 186 on good volume. Another one, even if the market's wimpy, these could be good traders. Take some profits the first day, maybe more than normal, unless there's really super volume and reason to hold. And then lastly, we will get another possible one here. It's another possibility of a short. At the beginning, it wouldn't be a big move, but see how it's pulled right down? It's had this indecisive candle near the lower Bollinger Band, but it had increased volume on that as well. So it could bounce, but last time it was 60.99. I guess at 60.99, right? So if it drops below that area, then we'll maybe get down to this 5750, where you can look over here back at the beginning of the year. It had some support there, but it could move down there. So anyway, that's what we have for this Friday. I hope you have a great weekend. Oh, because it's a weekend, we'll have a newsletter coming out. It's free. Just go to the homepage and put your address there, and we will send that out to you. And we'll put out some tweets, of course, during the day on Friday, so pay attention to those. Otherwise, have a super weekend, and we'll be back for a new video to watch list editions for the weekend as well. So have yourself a good summer weekend, and see you soon. Bye-bye.